Hello learners, welcome back in the next lecture of electrostatics. In this lecture we try to cover up these following 11 topics: line integral of electric field, electric potential and potential difference, electric potential due to a single point charge, electric potential due to a group of charges, electric potential due to an electric dipole, equipotential surfaces and their properties, electrostatic potential energy, area vector, solid angle, electric flux, Gauss theorem and its verification, Coulomb's law from Gauss theorem and different applications of Gauss theorem. Okay, so maybe this video can be long enough, so we will try to split up these lectures in small videos. So let's discuss on the line integral of electric field. As per as our last concern, we had already discussed that field of anything is just representable in the term of force with respect to per unit charge. Okay, so when we discuss on the electric field, it basically comes from the work done and it is the line integral of electric field. So negative line integral of electric field represents the work done by the electric field on a unit positive charge in moving it from one point to another in the electric field. So as you seen in this diagram, suppose there is a 3D structure, 3D frame of reference, OX, OY and OZ, representable two points A and B, and there is a point between A and B where charge plus Q naught is established, and we try to calculate the work done in bringing this charge from infinity to particular this point. Okay, so the total work done by the electric field on the test charge is moving from A to B in the electric field is WAB equals to integral of dW, which means minus E dot dl equal to QQ naught by 4 pi epsilon naught times 1 by RB minus 1 by RA, where RB and RA is the radius vector of point A and point B. So this is all about the line integral. So the question shown that the work done in moving a test charge Q naught from point A to another point B along any path AB in an electric field due to plus Q charge depends only on the positive of these points and is independent of the actually path followed by A to B. That is, the line integral of electric field is path independent. Okay, so which means the path independent, it means the work done by this method is actually a conservative work done. Okay, because it doesn't depend upon the path, as we had already discussed such type of forces, such type of work done in our 11th classes. So therefore electric field is a conservative field. Okay, line integral or electric field over a closed path is zero. That is another condition satisfied by the conservative field, that line integral of electric field is actually a zero. Okay, this is a very important factor. This formula is a very important equation. Please remember it. In fourth or fifth unit, we will discuss this particular equation under Maxwell equations also. So line integral of only static electric field is independent of the path followed. However, the line integral of the field due to a moving charge is not independent of the path because the field varies with the time. Now we are discussing on electric potential. Okay, so before studying the electric potential, we must understood what is potential energy. Okay, so whenever we perform any type of work done on any body, so that work done is stored in form of potential energy, and when we calculate the potential energy per unit any quantity, then it is called potential. For example, if you try to calculate electric potential, then it is electric potential energy per unit charge. When we try to calculate gravitational potential energy, then it is gravitational potential energy per unit mass. When you try to calculate magnetic potential, then it is magnetic potential energy per unit magnetization. So basically, potential is also a very broad sense. Okay, it have very broad sense. It can be used in several form. But here we are focused only on electric potential. And since electric potential is the quantity which is responsible for electric potential is charge, that's why the electric potential energy per unit charge is called electric potential. So as per here is mentioned that electric potential is the physical quantity which determines the flow of charge from one body to another. It is a physical quantity that determines the degree of electrification of a body. Electric potential at a point in the electric field is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that particular point. Okay, so if you go through this equation, then if we try to calculate the electric potential energy, so first we calculate the electric potential energy and then we divide that equation with the test charge and finally we get our total electric potential. The SI unit of electric potential is joule per coulomb or newton meter per coulomb. So electric potential at a point is 1 volt if 1 joule of work done is moving on 1 coulomb charge from infinity to that particular point in the electric field. Now the electric potential difference. So if you bring any particular charge from infinity to the electric field at point B and the similarly from infinity to at particular point A, so the difference between the electric potential of point B and point A is actually called electric potential difference, which is VB minus VA equals to delta V equals to WAB by Q naught. Electric potential and potential difference are scalar quantities. So electric potential at infinity is zero. Electric potential near an isolated positive charge. Isolated positive charge, which means charge is having the value greater than zero. Okay. And negative charge means less than zero. CGS unit of electric potential is stat volt. So one stat volt equals to 1 erg per stat coulomb. Electric potential due to a single point charge. Okay, electric potential due to a single point charge. So suppose there is a charge plus Q here and we try to calculate the electric potential due to this charge at point P. So first we will try to calculate the work done of bringing this charge to that point particular P. So the force acting between them is Q naught E. If E is the electric field emitting out from the charge, then dW equals to F dot dx, Q naught E times dx. And now we put the value of E, which is Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught x square. And since x is the distance between these two charges, so E equals to Q by 4 pi epsilon naught x square on integrating the value dW from infinity to R Q Q naught by 4 pi epsilon naught x square dx. And finally we get the relation of electric potential Q upon 4 pi epsilon naught R. This is the value of electric potential due to a single charge or a single point charge. So if you observe here, then from this equation, electric potential V is also inversely proportional to the 1 upon R. Okay, since 4 pi epsilon naught is a constant quantity and charge is also constant, so this whole function is representing that electric potential inversely proportional to the distance at which you try to calculate potential. So from here we can draw a graph for the same. Let's suppose this is a V and this is here 1 by R. So as you increase the distance, the electric potential also increases. And if you increase the distance, the value of potential decreases. Now, electric potential due to a group of point charges. So as electric potential is not a vector quantity, okay, so it is a scalar. So it is very easy to calculate the electric potential due to a group of point charges. We have to do what? We just try to add all the potentials at a particular point and then we get our answer. This is not a very big deal. So electric potential at a point due to a charge is not affected by the presence of other charges because it is a scalar quantity. So potential V proportional to 1 upon R, whereas Coulomb force is F proportional to 1 upon R square. Potential is a scalar, whereas force is a vector. Although potential is called the potential at a point, it is a scalar equal to the potential difference between point R and infinity. So for now, we should conclude this video till here. In further, we will try to study the electric potential due to a dipole and how the electric potential depends on different type of surfaces. What is the concept of equipotential surfaces and then Gauss theorem and other applications. Thank you, learners.